though, Hal.
Sure.
This is Hal.
The sinusoidal wave.
It's me.
Tennis.
We are going to measure the baseline. The baseline is this line right here. Step one is to measure how the distance from this point all the way down to that point. And 162 for the other half. We measured the baseline because the distance we already measured would be our amplitude for our y-axis. This would be 0. Down here would be our low point of our y-axis. Up here would be our high point of our y-axis for our sinusoidal wave. Step two is to time. Scott, our official timer, will time how long it takes me to run from the high point to the low point and the high point.
Shuffled for 9 seconds.
So for the calculations, we will draw a tennis court first. And we measured that the distance from this point to the middle was 162 inches. And we also measured from the middle to the low point was also 162 inches, making our amplitude 162 inches, because our middle of our baseline would be 0. Our period is 9 seconds. It's 9 seconds because it took me to run from the high point to the low point and high point again. The high point, because this is your tennis court. I ran from here down to here and back up.
Now for the graph.
Wow, look at those straight lines.
For the amplitude, it was 162 on top, 0 is the midpoint, and negative 162 is the low point. The period is 9 seconds because it took Jay 9 seconds to run from the high point to the low point and back. The midpoint between 9 and 0 is 4.5 seconds. The midpoint between 0 and 4.5 is 2.25 seconds. The midpoint between 4.5 and 9 is 6.75 seconds. This graph is a cosine graph because J started at the high point here of 162. So you put your point there, then you decrease to 0, decrease to negative 162, then you increase back to 0, and increase again back to 162. Now to draw your graph, you draw just over the lines using curved lines. If you want to draw a second period, you just add 9 seconds to the first period, making this 18 seconds. The midpoint point between 9 and 18 is 13.5 seconds. The midway point between 9 and 13.5 is 11.25 seconds. And the midpoint between 13.5 and 18 is 15.75 seconds. Then you draw the dots the same way that you would the first time. You would decrease down to 0, decrease to -162, increase back to 0, and increase again to 162. You draw the line the same way that you did the first time. Don't forget to add your X and Y labels. The Y axis is the length of the baseline, and the X axis is your time.
And that is our graph. Now it's time for our equation. Going off with y equals a. A is our amplitude. Trig function. B is the b value of x. Plus and minus c. C is the horizontal shift. Plus and minus d, which is our vertical shift. We do have a, which is 162 inches, based upon the 162 difference between 0 and 162. Our trig function is cosine, because we started off at a high point of 162, going down to a negative 162 and going back up to 162. Our b value, we don't know that. We have to find it. Our c value is 0, because we don't have a horizontal shift. But we do have a vertical shift, which is d of 162 inches. Because from 0 to 162 is 162. Alright, so to find b, that's what we're looking for. It's b of x period equals 2 pi, because we're dealing with radians of the unit circle. It's 2 pi b of our period, which is 9 seconds, is 2 pi. How did I get 9 seconds? That's our one period, from 0 to 9. And so we find our b value, which is 2 pi over 9. Now let's put it together. Y equals 162 cosine of 2 pi over 9 x plus, we don't have a c value, so we just leave it, plus 162, because that's our d value, which is our vertical shift. And that is our equation.
So let's recap on what we did. We found the amplitude to be 162 inches because that was one of the sides of the tennis court, one of the lengths and the other length. We found our period to be 9 seconds because that's how long it took me to run from the high to the low and back to the high in our tennis court. This is our high, low, and back to high. And this is our graph. again with the y and the x-axis. It's a cosine graph because I started at 162 inches all the way down to negative 162 inches and back up. And then here's our equation that we found to be 162 cosine of 2 pi over 9x plus 162.
Thanks for watching.
We hope you enjoyed the video on how to make a sinusoidal graph using tennis.
Go Trig!